الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده عيد مبارك يا الله سبحانه وتعالى بلسه ورقادره كل عام وأنتم بخير May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this blessed Eid upon us and upon all those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed with His hospitality, with His company in the blessed land of Mecca. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from them. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala return them safe and return them forgiven like the day they were born. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the blessings of those days for those who have made the Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a repeat, inshaAllah, and bless your Hajj. And for those who haven't, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you, inshaAllah, the time to have the blessings of visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Labbayk Allahumma labbayk. Labbayk la sharika laka labbayk. Inna alhamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk. La sharika laka labbayk. This is the beautiful dua, the beautiful saying of all of those who have destined themselves to visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who have taken upon themselves this arduous journey. But this is our life's calling, my dear brothers and sisters. These are the days that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a celebration for our ibadat, our ta'at. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our lives centered around His ta'at. We don't call a day a Eid until we celebrate one of the ta'at that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. After Ramadan, we celebrate Eid al-Fitr. And after al-Hajj, we celebrate Eid al-Adha, the day in which all of the ibadat are gathered and completed all in the same season. Alhamdulillah. The pillar of Hajj is only completed in those blessed 10 days that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that there is not days better in action and in what you can do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that these days, alhamdulillah, we have completed them. Our brothers and sisters, only a day before, in the day of Arafah, were in the mountain, raising their hands, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness, getting as close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as we can as human beings. My dear brothers and sisters, there is not a side closer to the side when we face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the side on the Mount of Arafah the day before. The Hajjij complete their ibadah of Hajj. For Hajj is the most important fundamental component of it, is Arafah. But then as they complete this, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them the opportunity to cleanse their sins, to get closer to Him like no other, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness, and seek His blessings, then they become worthy of visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then they break whatever shortcomings that they may have by their udhiyah and by their shaving of their head and by seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all of the rituals that we do. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Most High, when we come upon Him, He wants to give us in his most generous way, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the blessing of forgiveness, the blessing of rahmah. There is not a day in which the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immerses earth more than the days of Arafah and the days to follow. Because people are in their highest degree of iman. This is what we need to do, my dear brothers and sisters. We anchor our lives in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We live and breathe and drink and eat and live by, sustain ourselves by the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the true understanding of our lives. And so this day is a day to celebrate. This day is to feel happy and accomplished. This day is to feel closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as such, it is a day of celebration. We need to train ourselves in the traditions of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and having the joy that comes and the joy that stays with us, and the joy that ought to be celebrated in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. my dear brothers and sisters, these days come upon us as we are challenged and as we face significant challenges in our ways. As Muslims in a land where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's will is for us to be here, this time, this part of history, this part of the world. And so, if we are to remember the blessings of this occasion of Hajj, we're not going to keep it devoid of the context of our time, of our reality. Yes, we will celebrate, and yes, we will be happy, and yes, we will remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at every occasion. But we will make a difference in the environment around us, and we will change, learning from the great lessons of our deen, the great lessons of our ibadah, the benefits of the strength of the soul that results from the closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gives us the chance to make a difference, gives us the chance to exchange and to make sure that conditions that we do not accept are conditions that ought to be changed. And that what we do in our own lives is something about making sure that the principles that the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala advocates are being implemented. My dear brothers and sisters, our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the days of Hajj, in his only Hajj sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Hajjatul Wada', Hajjatul Islam, the scholars used to call it because it was the first and last of his Hajjs, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he made three speeches. He made a speech in the day of Arafah, he made a speech in the day of An-Nahr, Yawm al-Hajj al-Akbar, the Eid, today's. And he made another one in one of the days of Ayyam al-Tashriq. And in it, he was espousing universal principles, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was relaying his message to the generations to come. You see, he responded to the calling of his forefather Ibrahim, alayhi as-salam, when he was ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring again the foundations of Mecca. He had to have the strength and he had to have the characteristics of those who makes a difference, those who change the world, those who can affect their environment. It started all by the great lady of Hajar radiallahu anha, alayha salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Ibrahim alayhi salam to go to a land that did not have anything, that did not have any signs of life. رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ. Oh Allah, you have ordered me to leave part of my offspring, to house them in a land that did not have any plantations in it, at your house, at your great house. It started from that day, because the right people were in the right place at the right time. When Hajar alayhi salam came with Ibrahim alayhi salam with her young son Ismail, she didn't know where she was going. But when Ibrahim alayhi salam told her that he's going to leave her in this place, not in the luxury of America, not in the riverfronts of everywhere, but rather in a place that is desolate, that is a desert, she was left alone. And then she would turn to Ibrahim alayhi salam, and she would ask him, is it Allah who ordered you to do this? Allah amaraka? And he would look at her, and he is in himself, if it wasn't for his steadfastness and belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would have not known that this is the right thing to do for her. And he would say yes. And then that lady would say, إِذَنْ لَنْ يُضَيَّعَنَا. He will not leave us. And he will not take care of us. And she didn't stay crying or worried about her lot. She started looking. She knew that this is her destiny. And she started going back and forth between the Mount of Safa and the Mount of Marwa 7 times. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed that the order will come from under the feet of Ismail alayhi salam, the crying young man who did not know any better because he was thirsty. And then And after which, we know what has taken place. Today, millions of us, every single year, go to celebrate the tradition of our mother Hajar alayhi salam. Every time we go between Safa and Marwa, we remember that with the real tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the will and the strength, things will happen. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed that more people came to this place. And it needed those who were strong in their faith, those who worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who knew that they were full of hope, that they were able to transform and bring forth a change. And so when Ibrahim alayhi salam was given the order to build the foundations of, or to rediscover the foundation of Mecca and rebuild it again, the Kaaba, he was given another test. Now, is he and his offspring, the youth, the young ones, the generation to come, are they worthy to withhold the pressure and be able to be patient and strong so that they can transform realities around them? They're not fazed by the difficulties they may face. They know if they are endowed with faith and strength, that they will be able to change the reality around them. And so the second test comes when Ismail alayhi salam is put to the test by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so is Ibrahim when he was ordered to slaughter his son. No father can do this. No father can look at his child and think that this is something that he can do. Yet, if he knew that it was the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the only other difficulty is convincing his offspring that this is something that Allah ordered. And so he would come up to his son and he says, Ya Bunay, inni ara fil manami anni adbahuk, fandur mada tara. Subhanallah. He didn't force him, he didn't fake it, he didn't, you know, made it so that he doesn't know. He asked him, are you ready to take on the responsibility? Are you ready to stand for your deed? Are you ready to withhold the difficulties that may be ahead? And his son, because he was raised right, his son was raised in the house of Nubuwwah, in the house that upholds the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What was his response? قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرُ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهِ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Do that which was your order. You will find me, inshallah, amongst the patient ones. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them both the salvation that we celebrate every single time we do Eid al-Adha. But my dear brothers and sisters, it took that kind of commitment. It took that kind of patience and perseverance to plant the seedlings of monotheism in the heartland of a desert that didn't have water, that didn't have plants, that didn't have people. But that determination, that strength of character, that patience, that perseverance were the prerequisites for the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the eternal optimism. Because when Ibrahim alayhi salam first asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that I have placed my offspring in a place that didn't have anything. رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ فَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ. He asked Allah to grant him, you know, the vision that he wants to see. A place that's prosperous, a place that brings people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to circumambulate the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to live in accordance with the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so when he was about to leave, he raised his arms to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and said, Oh Allah, without you, I can't do anything. How can my voice reach out to the rest of humanity? And then he did, because he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with him. So he said, Ya ayyuhan nas, kutiba alaykum al-hajj ila al-bayt al-atiq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ. It was a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنْ تَنْصُرُ اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ. This is the promise that we need to be revitalized around. This is the promise that we need to be encouraged by. And so what was the answer? When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the offspring of Ismail and the offspring of Ibrahim alayhi as-salam, made his Hajj, there was over 100,000 people with him. Those are the people that spread the light to the rest of the world. And when we go today to those lands, we see millions of people answering the call. My dear brothers and sisters, this is home for us. This is where our children are. This is where the seedlings of monotheism are being sown. This is where Ismail is being reared. This is where Ibrahim must stand up. And this is where Hajar must come forth in our community. Just yesterday, we had to deal with the 15th anniversary of the tragic events of the heinous attack on our homeland here. In the name of terrorism, today, Islam is being shunned. The Islam we believe in are the Islam of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Islam that he reminded us of when he completed his ibadat. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his khutbas in the Hajj, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to say, Ya ayyuhal nas, أي يوم هذا؟ قالوا يوم حرام هو يوم الحج الأكبر. قال فأي بلد هذا؟ قالوا هي بلد الحرام. فقال فأي شهر هذا؟ فقالوا هذا شهر حرام. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم فإن دماءكم وأموالكم وأعراضكم عليكم حرام كحرمة يومكم هذا في بلدكم هذا في شهركم هذا. The Islam that you and I believe in is the Islam of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was circumambulating the Kaaba. In the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar, he would say, مَا أَطْيَبَكِ وَأَطْيَبَ رِيحِكِ مَا أَعْضَمُكِ وَأَعْضَمَ حُرْمَتِكِ وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ لَحُرْمَةِ الْمُؤْمِنِ أَعْضَمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ حُرْمَةً مِنْكِ مَالُهُ وَدَمُهُ وَأَنَّ ظُنُّ بِهِ خَيْرًا. My dear brothers and sisters, our Islam is being hijacked by those who want to denigrate and demonize this Islam, and we will not stand for it. If we are to make sure that we are upstanding citizens of our nation, we are patriots who will save our nation from destroying itself, then we will be the ones that define what Islam is, not have somebody else define it for us. We will be the ones that stand up to the bigots and to the racists and who will make a difference in November and beyond November. My dear brothers and sisters, we mourn the loss of life in our nation, and we mourn the loss of life everywhere in the world where there is bigotry, racism, injustice, oppression. And by far, by Allah, we get the greater share of it. Our ummah is the ummah that's suffering today from these injustices. And so we will make it right, both here at home and both abroad. And we will not accept for us to look the other way when everybody blames and everybody points the finger as to who are the purveyors of violence. Our deen is the source of peace. Our deen is our source to be the upstanding citizens who will make a difference and who will change our reality. And so as we celebrate our Eid, we remember the great Hajar and the great Ibrahim and the great Ismail. And we will stand, inshallah, to bring their legacy forth. And bring it so that we can show the world what Islam is and stand for what is Islam. This is not a somber occasion, my dear brothers and sisters, but this is an occasion to rejuvenate and re-strengthen and reapply oneself. Let us, inshallah, celebrate our Eid. Teach your children today about who Ismail is. And teach our sisters who Hajar is. And teach ourselves who Ibrahim is. And above all, let us, inshallah, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the company of our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Eid Mubarak, kullu amin wa antum bikhir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our community and bless our country and make these days the blessed ones and bless our world. Allahumma ameen. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Kullu amin wa antum bikhir wa Eid Mubarak. يا الله يا الله يا الله.